Today, we're going to go through one of the newer tools added to the LT3 Raptor software, which is curved waterfalls. Curved waterfalls are going to be a radius that we then add an arc to and then create the pieces off to be able to create a curved waterfall. So first thing we're going to do is go to offset, and we're going to just make sure we have the miter color, and we're going to do a base offset. This is going to make sure that our corners are away from the cabinetry. We're going to fillet this all together. Once we fillet that together, we're going to just do the bump out tool. The bump out tool allows me to set my distance. We're going to click at the beginning, the end, and put on a simple radius. Now we're going to go to tools, curved waterfall. We're going to now click on our radius. This allows us multiple options. We can do equal piece sizes, and we can set how many pieces are there. As we change this, it will change the segment width down here and will tell you how many segments. The other option we have is we can set our piece width. If we want to do 2-inch pieces, we can do 2-inch pieces all the way around, but at the beginning and the end, we are going to end up with a 1-inch piece. This is going to allow us to be able to get the proper width with good angles from the beginning to the end. I'm going to stick with equal widths. We can set our height based off of whatever we want to set that to. We can also label our pieces alphabetically, numerically. If we end up with multiple of them on the same piece, we can even add prefixes. This is going to help us to obviously label A waterfall from B waterfall. When we go through to do this and we hit the create button, it's going to create all of the pieces. Now I can move this, I can leave it right where it is, but I'm going to just click off the piece and click on cancel. At this point, we end up with all of our individual pieces. And if we zoom in, you're even going to see that we get our straight lines around our radius to show where they are going to meet. The biggest and the hardest thing is figuring out all of the angles. I just can go to distance and angles, and it will show you the angle that each piece now has to be cut to.